Good morning. Good morning, all. God bless you. Pastor Michael here. I pray that you are well this morning and resting in the Lord. Amen. Today I want to just have a very brief talk to you this morning about our safety. It is in the Lord. Different surroundings today. I'm actually at work. I had to come into work to check on the premises and make sure a couple of things are sorted out. So safety in the Lord. My thought for this morning is that we must find our sufficiency in the Lord, our safety in the Lord, our strength in the Lord, our trust in the Lord. And the scriptures, a few scriptures from the book of Psalms 33 is what came to my attention when I was beginning to meditate and pray about this. So Psalm 33, I'm going to read you a few verses from this. Psalms 33, it says, "Rejoice in the Lord, right, O you righteous, for praise is comely for the upright." Verse 3, it says, "Sing unto him a new song, play skillfully with a loud noise, for the word of the Lord is right, and all his works are done in truth." Verse 6 says, "By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all the host of them by the breath of his mouth." So a couple of things to start off with here. It is incumbent upon the believer to understand how to access God's presence through praise, through prayer, through worship at any given moment. We can't wait for a catastrophe or a calamity to befall us to understand how to access the presence of God. The believer must know that they are righteous in him and in his presence, and must know that we can access his presence because of his blood that was shed for us and gave us access beyond the veil. And based upon these foundational principles, we must be able to know, I give him all my worship, I give him all my praise at any given moment. So it says, "Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous, for praise is comely for the upright." That means praise must always be in our mouth. We must always have a declaration and a confession to make about our God, especially in times like this, where we take for granted going out. We take for granted going to the shops. We take for granted the liberty and the freedom that we have. And as believers, we must have a strong conviction of our faith that knows, God, I give you all praise. All praise is due to you. I worship you if I have, and I worship you if I don't have. Nothing will shift my praise for you if I am restricted or restrained from having anything. So praise must be a basic part of the believer's diet. It says, sing a new song to the Lord. You've got to have a song in your mouth. You've got to have a praise in your spirit. Verse 6 says, "By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all of the host of them by the breath of his mouth." Now, I don't know about you, but more and more, maybe it's because I'm getting older, I'm realizing more and more that really, outside of God, there really is nothing else. Our sufficiency comes from him. Our ability comes from him. Our aptitude, our gifts, our talents are all stemming from his and his grace. Without him, I am nothing. Without him, I can do nothing. And it's bringing me closer and closer to this absolute dependency upon the Lord. So verse 6 clarified it quite clearly. We're talking about our safety is in the Lord this morning. "By the word of the Lord were the heavens made, and all of the host of them by the breath of his mouth." Look at verse 8. "Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the inhabitants of the world stand in awe of him." There's one of the things that I don't know if you have noticed, which is how many countries are beginning to call for national days of prayer. how many countries, Jamaica, Brazil, Venezuela, all nations are beginning to cry out corporately because something is afflicting them which has taken away man's own strength, intellect, prowess to deal with situations and are having to call upon the unseen God, the God that is the God of the believers, then cry out and call for national days of prayer so that people can come together praying for mercy. Amen. In times of need. Let's read on. Verse 11. The counsel of the Lord stands forever, the thoughts of his heart to all generations. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and the people who he has chosen for his own inheritance. My gosh. Remember, church, when I did that series on the counsel of his will, and it brings back this fire in my spirit that there is nothing other than the counsel of the Lord that we can trust on as God's people. We have to know what God's counsel is. What, I don't care what man says. I don't care what chief scientific officer says. I don't care what this person who's an expert of that says. What's God saying on the matter? Unless God is speaking and his church are hearing, I'm sorry. As far as I am concerned, the conclusion of the matter is amen in Christ and Christ alone. So the counsel of the Lord stands forever. That means forever means perpetually, eternally. Nothing can change outside of that. The counsel of the Lord stands forever, the thoughts of his heart to all generations. So remember, I was saying to you yesterday that as we were talking about communion, my heart, I sense such a largeness of God's heart over the nations of the earth and for his people. And here we read today, the thoughts of his heart to all generations. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. Can a nation change in a day? Yes, I believe it can. Can this situation be changed in a day? Yes, I believe it can. What is the key? When the nation turns to God. But you know what one of the keys is that those who are in leadership of the nation must repent, must turn, and must call for not just a day of prayer, but sanctify and consecrate this land. I said yesterday, as I was driving back from work, the streets were desolate. The streets were quiet. There was nothing going on. There was a few cars here and there, a few people walking about. And in my spirit, such a strength pushed. And I heard these words that while the streets are quiet, the prayer closets are rumbling with the sounds of prayer about this issue. All over the nation, people are in their houses praying for an end to this. All over the world, Europe, Africa, Asia, the Americas, people are coming together to pray. Why? Because there's a need to press into the presence of God, to seek God whilst he may be found. The Bible says in 1 Chronicles, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves and seek my face, I will hear from heaven and heal the land. So it is incumbent upon us as believers to know that the Lord's word is sure and it will not return to him void. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and the people whom he has chosen for his own inheritance. Last couple of verses, 18, 19. It says, behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy. We've got to be crying out for mercy, church. We've got to be crying out to the Lord and asking the Lord, Father, forgive us of our sins. Whatever we have done as mankind, to perpetuate sin and sickness on the earth, we repent. Your land, your earth is crying out. Romans chapter 8 says, the earth groans and travails, waiting for the sons of God to arise. Will you be a son of God this morning? And will you be calling out to God on behalf of this nation, on behalf of our country, on behalf of this kingdom that should be united, united in prayer, and seek God's face desperately for God to deliver us? He says that behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their souls from death and to keep them alive in famine. Amen? To keep us alive in famine. Father, I'm not just quoting Psalm 91 because it's a cute psalm to speak and it's the popular psalm to declare. I'm quoting it because my roots of my faith are intertwined inextricably and irrevocably with those words of Psalm 91. He who dwells under the secret place of the Most High and under the shadow of the Almighty, I'm telling you, it goes on to say, no harm shall befall you. Why? Because you dwell in that secret place. Though behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. Verse 20, our soul waits for the Lord. He is our help and our shield, for our heart shall rejoice in him, because we have trusted in his holy name. Jesus, let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us according as we hope in thee. It's very clear. The scripture is all very clear. Let us find our hope and our strength in him. Let us fear the Lord. Behold, the eyes of the Lord are upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. Lord, we trust in you. Our safety is in you. Our sufficiency is in you. Our security is in you. Lord, the Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. We come to you, Father, today in the name of Jesus, and we repent on behalf of this nation, whatever this nation has done to cause this curse of coronavirus to befall this nation. We ask for your forgiveness right now in the name of Jesus. We turn aside and seek your face today in the precious and mighty name of Jesus, that you would, as your scripture declares, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, that shall they hear from heaven and you will heal the land. Father, we ask you in the name of Jesus, cause your spirit to sweep across this nation and cleanse it, Lord, from this coronavirus in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we turn our hearts towards you. We fear you, O God, because you are God alone and there is none beside you, Father. Our sufficiency and our strength is on you today and every day in Jesus' precious name. Amen. The last two verses say, our heart shall rejoice in him because we have trusted in his holy name. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us according as we hope in you. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you right now. Amen, church. Be blessed. Stand strong in the Lord. Cause your sufficiency and your faith and your security to be in the Lord. And let it not be in natural things. Let it not be in material things, but let it be in this time. There is a refining that is happening, that the Lord is wanting the believer's faith to be secure in the sufficiency and the knowledge of him. In Jesus' precious name, amen. God bless you.